forensic medicine, practical record, drunkenness certificate, record writing. In this video, I want to emphasize how to write drunkenness certificate. First of all, drunkenness defined as a state of person who consumed alcohol in a such a sufficient quantity by which he is influenced by the alcohol. In such an extent, he is unable to perform the job in which he is engaged in the material time safely. The safety is the important. Even drunkard person can perform more efficiently, but the safety measures are lost. They are prone for accidents, unnatural deaths, injuries. That's why the alcohol influence while driving, performing any skilled activities, risky activities, is dangerous, hazardous. In this regard, we are not encouraging doing works or jobs under the influence of alcohol. Next, what are the stages of alcohol? What is the condition of the body in relation to the alcohol percentage in blood? For example, if it is 30 milligrams of alcohol in blood, the condition of the body, mind condition, mood, connectivity, sociability, physical performances, reflexes, everything is under control. So that is the legal limit. 30 milligrams of alcohol concentration in blood is the legal limit in India. But practically, up to 50 milligrams, a person is not much influenced by alcohol. Moreover, the alcohol will be energetic, a tonic of social mobility, sociability. Up to 80 milligrams of blood alcohol concentration, practically it is encouraged. So that's why some of the developed countries are permitting up to 80 milligrams of alcohol during their even driving. But in India, only 30 milligrams. After 80 milligrams, what will happen? Slowly, confusion, muscle incoordination, impairment of judgment, slowing of muscle reflexes, tendon reflexes, reaction time is increased after 80 milligrams of percentage. So, stage of influence will start after 80 milligrams. That's why alcohol is not recommended more than 80 milligrams of percentage in blood. Even though somebody has consumed alcohol in such an extent, they have to try to minimize alcohol concentration in blood by increasing their physical activity and allowing the liver to metabolize. Liver can metabolize 30 milligrams per hour. So somebody has consumed 100 milligrams means they have to wait for 2-3 hours before going for driving or skilled work, any risky work. So based on this knowledge, I will emphasize how to write drunkenness certificate. Any medical legal report is having three parts: preamble, observation and opinion. In preamble, routinely I am saying requisition received from. Before that, we have to mention what is your medico-legal case number and FIR number. Two numbers and requisition received from station house officer or police officer or magistrate. Usually magistrate won't request, only some exceptional cases. After police request, we can start examining a drunkard person. Preferably, if he is conscious, fully oriented, we can take his consent. If he is not much oriented, the consent is not much valid. In such case, we have to take some his relations or bystanders or relations like that. Next, preliminary data of the drunken person, his name, age, sex, occupation, address, identification marks. That about the preliminary data, we have to go for general examination. General examination is what is basically appearance. Appearance, clothes, speech, gait, and other activities. How it is conjunctiva, respiration, speech, social behavior, all those things we can observe. Next, tests for muscle coordination. Demonstration of finger nose test. Ask the patient to stretch the hand, then ask him to touch the finger nose. First we have to stretch, or asking examiner's hand and drunken person's hand, finger to finger test, finger nose test, or picking coins from the ground, walking in straight line, or simply walking. In such case, we can observe the stance, gait, instability, any staggering, any slippage, any delayed, or any loss of balance. In such case, at the same time, you have to protect the individual from injuries. With due precautions, we have to conduct all these examinations because they are prone for injuries because of our examination. That should not be encouraged. Next, alcohol gauge nystagmus. Even in foreign countries, the police officers also are trained how to conduct roadside alcohol gauge nystagmus. For example, asking the patient to follow an object without moving the neck or head, just eyeballs, they have to follow up to 45 or 60 degrees. After following the object by 45 degrees, there is a nystagmus movement. The nystagmus movements are jerky movements with slow return. Jerky outward movements with slow return. That is alcohol gauge nystagmus can be elicited in certain amount of alcohol percentage in blood. Next, make one sign and all only after higher concentrations, especially the patient is sustained head injury and at the influence of alcohol. We have to rule out the coma is because of head injury or coma only after 300 milligrams of blood alcohol concentration. In such conditions, we have to check for make you one sign. Give a usually alcohol and because of alcohol influence, pupil is dilated. So all the bars are poorly illuminated. For the convenience of the alcohol, once we start taking alcohol, the pupils become dilated. The drunkards are not comfortable with the bright light. That's why the illumination in the bars are low. But in stage of coma, that is after 300 milligrams, the pupils are constricted. Another stage after muscle incoordination. Muscle incoordination confusion starts by 80 milligrams, peak by 200. After 200, the person will go into stuporous condition, that is stupor. Stupor is unable to move his limbs with relative consciousness of his orientation. Relative preservation of consciousness. The person is unable to move his limbs, just like sleep-like condition, is called stupor. He cannot able to reach his home after consumption of alcohol. He may lie down in the traffic island or next to the gutter or in the car itself or sometimes in the bar itself. He is sleeping, but it is not sleep, it is a stupor. Next stage, 200 to 300 stupor will continue. After 300 or after 400, definitely alcoholic coma will ensue. McEwan's sign is to differentiate coma either because of head injury or alcohol. By simple test, bedside test, clinical test, simple giving some slap or pinching of skin, giving some painful stimulus, the people will become dilated and slow return by 20 minutes. If the McEwan sign is positive, coma is because of alcohol, not because of head injury. Based on these fundamental things, we can do some certain things. Then, alcometer, breath analyzer, we can do perform simultaneously. Under observations, all these points we can see. Speech also, slurring of the speech, conjunctiva is congested or infused in alcohol condition. The thing is, after observation, we are making it, person has consumed alcohol or not. That can be elicited by presence of alcohol smell in the breath. The alcoholic odor is not a pleasant smell. It is a disagreeable fruity odor. One person is taken alcohol and he is occupying a small room, means the entire room atmosphere will spoil. Just like smoking, alcoholics also will spoil the room atmosphere by their exhaled air, which contains disagreeable fruity odor. Even alcoholics cannot tolerate that smell. Next, alcoholic odor or disagreeable fruity odor in the breath is an indication of the person has consumed alcohol. Next, person has consumed alcohol but not under its influence. That means reflexes are normal, not sluggish. Muscle coordination is normal, not affected. Reaction time also normal. See, all these things factors, we can say that person has consumed alcohol but he is not under its influence. The third one, neither alcoholic odor nor muscle incoordination. Even then, there may be some imbalance of stance or conscious level. That may be because of some other drug or some other metabolic condition or some other neurological condition, but not because of alcohol. These are the things we can give opinion, three kind of opinion. I forgot to emphasize the history of the alcoholism before that, how he consumed alcohol, in what a form, or before food or after food, or with soda, without soda, or cool or warm. All those factors will affect its absorption. And what is his activity after consumption of alcohol? That is, he is simply sitting and drinking without food. he is sitting, drinking and showing some physical activity. All those factors will affect its metabolism. And he is a chronic alcoholic or freshly taking. All these factors will affect the blood alcohol concentration. Next, what are the neurological conditions which mix alcohol condition, intake condition? Cerebellar ataxia, sensory neuropathy, or some other neurological disorders which affect the speech, gait, stance and balance, which are the differential diagnosis for alcohol intake. What are the drugs will cause altered sensorium? Diazepam, clonazepam, antipsychotics, or other drugs like cocaine, delirians like datura or cannabis. So these are the differential diagnosis. How we are going to differentiate because of the smell in alcohol, smell of alcohol in exhaled breath. Next, these are the pathognomonic things. Based on this criteria, you start writing record. Thank you, my dear students.